What a figure of a man the Dutchman provides. How he fits this into this weight category, I'm not quite sure. You just stand up from the squatting position and you will see immediately the huge height advantage that he has. Long, long legs, long arms.
He's very light on his feet. He's constantly in motion. He has a beautiful straight 1-2. Comes right down the middle and it comes with remarkable speed.
That foot comes from way back. It wasn't super fast, but you could see it carried some weight. It's going to be all Shimoishi can do to stay out of range there. His target will be to get within range, get inside those long arms, see what he can achieve.
Nice little big old looping right hook there landed by Shimoishi. As soon as he gets inside that striking range, once he gets in that boxing range, he's able to throw those hands, and Shimoishi's got very heavy hands.
The judo black belt looking to get within range. 1 minute into this contest, 3 5-minute rounds. Impact Arena in Bangkok. Big night ahead. Two world title contests. And Shimoishi has got Buist on his back, driving him into the circle wall.
Nice little single as he ends up in mount. That was a beautiful way that he was able to clear the legs and end up in this mount position. He hooked the outside leg and he stepped over with the other and he actually slid it up and then managed to climb underneath it. It was beautiful. The strategy as far as getting into that advantageous position. Now he's sitting in Buist's half guard. Now he's got his back up against the fence there.
Buist looks remarkably calm. Let's see if he can maintain that.
Buist is very tricky off his back. He's got good submissions and he's got those long legs so he can actually find submissions quite well, especially in the triangle.
Head pushed up against the circle wall. Still looks very calm. That left hand over the neck of his opponent. Just bringing him close, keeping him nice and tight. Good work with the left hand though from Shimoishi. Japanese man just working to try and improve position. Using the right hand now to dig into the side of the Dutchman.
You see Buist trying to scoot over onto his side, but Shimoishi's keeping that underhook on his right side, so Buist is not able to get the underhook on his left arm, so he can start moving away and creating a little bit of space. Shimoishi's just got such a heavy top game. He's always in control. Just shutting down everything Buist is trying to do. Now he's trying to pass over into mount. Easily steps over into mount.
That long body, is it tougher on the back pitch to try and manipulate positions when you're so much rangier than your opponent?
Here we go. It's often said that when, you know, you're on the ground, that height advantage kind of gets nullified, and Shimoishi does a beautiful job of stepping over into the back position. Now he's got the back, now he's got the seatbelt. Nice little escape there. Now he's trying to work that rear naked choke. Good job by Buist to get off of him. He's got good scrambling. You can see how Buist is constantly moving. You know, he's able to roll now into half guard. So he's pretty tricky off his back just as far as maneuvering and giving up worse positions to get into better ones.
It's kind of ragdolled Buist for a moment there, showing very good strength.
This is where Shimoishi excels. He does a good job of controlling the top position.
Forcing that head into the Dutchman's face. There's no headbutt there, but he's trying to control position by just pressing his head down there. If you control the Dutchman's head, there's a lot less that Buist can do about his positioning.
Shimoishi might be looking for an arm triangle there. Good job by Buist to hip bump and reverse out.
He's got the throat, that left arm around the throat.
Possible guillotine here from Buist. He's got that hand, the forearm right there on his left side, underneath the chin.
Hooked it up with his arm as well. Slips out of it.
Good job by Shimoishi to clear that arm.
Shimoishi seems to be slightly marked just above and to the right of his right eye. It doesn't look like anything serious at all. Just a raise really.
Good trip from Shimoishi right there as Buist was trying to swing his arm in. Shimoishi went for the trip.
Inside the body half minute.
Can you do with this body lock here in the last 20 seconds? He might just take him over the left side. You can see him trying to step in with the leg there. Yep, there he goes, turns the corner. Just real heavy in that body lock takedown attempt. Buist trying to swim in, trying to take his arm, shove it in between the arms there of Shimoishi.
Even in this stand-up position, Shimoishi trying to control Baust's head with his own. And that was a 5 minutes that Baust salutes with a little puff out of his cheeks there, because that was hard work for him for the bulk of that five. So this is where he likes to be, Mitch, in this position, but it didn't work out too well for him from there on.
Yeah, he was able to catch the leg kick and just drive in, just fully committed to the takedown. And then once he got it on to the ground, Shimoishi had a lot of success, you know, with the ground and pound advancing position. It was ground control because he's able to advance his position. He's not just sitting in the guard and trying to soften up Baust. He's actually advancing his position. He transitioned from side mount into mount. He was, you know, Baust was able to be, you know, get back into, you know, half guard a couple of times, but Shimoishi was just the more effective grappler in a lot of those exchanges. So good job by Shimoishi to score some heavy ground control in that first round.
Shimoishi can bang. He's got 4 knockout victories, but 7 submission wins. He likes to grind it out. 10 wins by decision. That's the kind of experience that Baust is up against. This 31-year-old man from Japan made it difficult for his rangy opponent in the latter half of that opening round. And can Baust keep this one on the feet? Flying knee, greeted enthusiastically by this wonderful crowd in Bangkok. It didn't take long for us to get back to the mat, Mitch.
Yeah, Baust's got to be a little bit more conservative. Nice flying knee landed flush on the chest of Shimoishi, but he did close that distance so quick. Shimoishi just wrapped him up, outside trip, back, dragged him right back down to the ground. Had side control. Now he's trying to work that head and arm. You can see he's trying to drive his head into the mat, and he's trying to get his head underneath the arm of Baust. Baust is doing a good job of preventing that from happening.
3 meters or so away from us here at circle side. Baust goes back to the canvas again, and he's now being treated to some full-out pressed onto his face. No actual blows, but that pressure. And a little bruising forearm there on top of the head.
Baust does a good job of preventing Shimoishi from really advancing too far in the ground control. So Baust kind of gives up a little bit, gives him a little bit of space, and right as Shimoishi tries to advance, Baust is able to transition and kind of regain, you know, back to his guard, or at least his half guard.
Nice clubbing, flat point of the elbow there from Shimoishi. Baust had his legs, his feet locked together a moment ago, but they've come apart. That should give Shimoishi a little bit more room to work with, pressing his opponent up against this circle wall now. Very uncomfortable position for the Dutchman to be in, and we can see right hands just slotting in to the left-hand side of Baust's face now. Nothing hard, but point scoring for sure.
So Baust is trying to control the right arm of Shimoishi, so he's trying to shove it down between his legs so he can take his left leg and shoot it up across the back of Shimoishi, possibly looking for a triangle. But Shimoishi is wise to it. And see how he, like you mentioned earlier, how he's controlling with his head. He's always driving his head into the chest or the underneath the chin of Baust, and that prevents a lot of Baust's movement.
We're reaching the halfway stage of this contest, and Pieter Buist is finding himself in a situation where he's finding it difficult to impress the judges. Just being dictated to by this man from Japan. Once again, the weight of the forearms come down on the Dutchman's forehead. Working with the fist as well. Getting tiring for the Dutchman.
So possibly looking for a kimura on the right side of Shimoishi. He's doing a good job of avoiding any major damage from Shimoishi. Baust is very defensive. He's able to block a lot of the oncoming ground and pound delivered by Shimoishi. He's always looking for submissions, you know, right? He's looking for kimuras, he's looking for triangles, but Shimoishi's just got too heavy of a top game.
You're right, there's been nothing significant landed, has there, in this position. But
now he's got the hand. See how he has the left hand of Baust trapped behind his arm there momentarily, kind of in a handcuff position.
See the Baust's face. Circle side. The knee comes in from Shimoishi, just fell short, and they're up on the feet again. It's a big flying knee, but comes back with a left and right. Shimoishi, good response. And he's down looking for the takedown again, but they're back up on the feet. A right hand of this crowd here in Thailand. What a turnaround, Mitch.
Pieter Buist can change the course of a match in an instant. And that's exactly what he did. Shimoishi was dominating him in that whole second round right there. But just a moment, one minor mistake was all Buist needed. Check this out right there. Shimoishi was going for the takedown. Buist goes up top, throws the kick, and lands a beautiful straight right hand. And then he goes after the knees, lands two beautiful knees, and the referee, three beautiful knees, and the referee was forced to jump in. Welcome to ONE Championship, Pieter Buist.
15-4 is his now improved record. When that opportunity presented itself, after really having been under the cosh for the greater part of this battle, he really jumped on it, didn't he? Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 55 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Pieter Buist!
The tall man, 1.9 centimeters tall, gets another victory, 15-4. Is his new record, the Archangel. And there he is with a big smile on his face. And that's the W that he's been looking for.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.